In world news now, Hamas has announced it has agreed to a ceasefire proposal from Egypt and Qatar. The latest framework calls for the release of 20 to 33 hostages over several weeks in exchange for a temporary ceasefire. In return, there would also be an exchange involving Palestinian prisoners held by Israel. Israel, however, says the current framework does not meet its requirements, and it plans to push ahead with an operation in Rafah. Right now, the director of the CIA is in the region working on those negotiations, and the Biden administration says the ceasefire proposal is under review. Alice Barr is in Washington with the latest on this developing situation.
A whiplash of hope and fear in Gaza today after the political wing of Hamas said it had tentatively accepted a ceasefire deal brokered by Egypt and Qatar. An Israeli official tells NBC News that proposal is not the framework that was agreed upon with mediators. The prime minister's office saying Israel will send a delegation back to the negotiating table. The White House also reviewing the proposal.
And we're discussing it with our partners in the region. Director Burns, as you know, is there, and he's working this in real time on the ground.
The Biden administration has been pressing for a ceasefire deal that would free Hamas-held hostages in exchange for Palestinian prisoners and get more aid into Gaza.
There has been a significant offer on the table. The ball has been in Hamas's court. We have made clear that they should accept that offer.
President Biden spoke today with Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. The president reiterated U.S. opposition to an Israeli ground assault on Gaza's southernmost city of Rafah, where more than a million civilians are sheltering. Palestinians in eastern Rafah packing up once again after leaflets and text messages from the Israeli military told some 100,000 people to move to a not quite safe but safer humanitarian zone to clear the way for significant force against terrorists. The prime minister's office says the Israeli war cabinet unanimously decided to continue the military operation in Rafah, which Israel considers the last Hamas stronghold, while pursuing a ceasefire. Here at home, simmering tensions on college campuses. Pro-Palestinian protesters clashed with police at the University of Virginia over the weekend, and today Columbia University in New York announced its main commencement ceremony is canceled. In Washington, Alice Barr, NBC News.